Good afternoon, everybody. We'll go ahead and get started tonight. I want to thank everybody for coming out and joining us, and hope you've had a blessed day, and a special welcome to those that are joining us on Facebook or YouTube. Welcome to our Wednesday night service here at Macklin Baptist Church. First announcement tonight, we have the Macklin Clothes Closet. It is now up and running. Got a big donation this Sunday towards that. So if you know of anybody in need in the community, let us know, let them know about us, and we'll make sure that we get the need sorted out there. You can get with Miss Tammy Bass if you need more information on that, or if you have any donations that you would like to make toward that, you can get with Miss Tammy as well. Our Macklin Food Pantry is now also open 24/7 to anybody in the community that's in need. It's on the side of our building. There's a sign on the door. Come in, help yourself, take what you need. And if you have donations that you would like to make towards that, you can leave those donations in that room as well. Everything's pretty well labeled as far as where everything goes and the types of items that we keep in there. I haven't checked on it recently, so I'm not sure how we're doing on the stock, but if you get a chance and can make a donation toward that, if you want to stop and look and see what items we need, that would be greatly appreciated. And you can get with Miss Annette Boyd if you need assistance on that. Our April community dinner will be April 10th, and our menu for this month is going to be turkey and dressing with all the fixings. This is going to be one of those times where our homecoming and Easter all fall at the same time, and it coincides with this dinner. So it's going to be our Easter dinner and our homecoming dinner, as well as our community dinner, all at the same time. So the church is going to provide the turkey and the dressing. Or just the turkey? Okay, just the turkey. And the church body, we need to help out with the dressing and the fixings. We already have the sign-up sheet on the board, so make sure you go get signed up to help out with that. And then we have a letter here from Beacon World Missions. It's one of the missions that we support, and they've sent an update. I haven't got to read it yet, but there's several pages here, and I'll make sure to hang this on the bulletin board so you can go by and check that out and read it as you can. But wanted to make sure everybody was aware that we did have that, and it would be on the bulletin board. We have any other announcements tonight? Okay. If not, prayer requests tonight. We have Brenda Garland, Sharon Stiefel, Jean Smith, Tina Gwynn, Bobby Huckabee, Barbara Craig, Joe Wheeler, Harley Turner, Angela Davis, Gwen Pittman, Bill Bain, the Cheryl Wilburn family. That's Brother Michael's stepmother, for those of you that didn't know. So be much in prayer for them during this time. Annette Boyd, Derek Guest, Tony Smith, PJ Greenwood, Rayford Clemens, Wayne Bailey, Audrey Smith, James Clark, James Barentine family, Cody Moore, Renee Atkins, Trish Sprague, Rhonda Johnson, Dot Ray, Trendon Hedrick, Patrick Wilson, Donald Thomas, Tanya Prey, Seth Disharoon, Bobby Adams, Corey Roberts, Mike Jett, Mary Posey, Jerry Selvage, Donna Monroe, Rodney Romans, the Chad Hughes family, Mike Lacey, Lisa Mitchell, Vivian Pitts, Cade McClendon, Kim Harvey, Lois Jackson, the Don Davis family, Janet Farmer, the Sean Free family, Nina and Bud Laney, Michael Rogers, Glenn Boyd, and Glenda Benefield. Do we have any other prayer requests tonight? Okay. If not, if you'll bow and go to the Lord in prayer with me. Lord, we come to you tonight, Lord, just thankful as always, thankful for another day that you've given us, Lord, to just wake up and serve you, Lord. Thankful for the opportunity, again, to come out to your house tonight, Lord, just to worship and praise you, Lord. Thankful for that sweet promise that we have in salvation, Lord, that this journey doesn't end here, Lord, that this is not our home, Lord, that we're going to a far, far better place if we have accepted you in the free pardon of sin, Lord. So thankful tonight for the sacrifice that Jesus made, Lord, and that it's about his worthiness and not about our worthiness, Lord. But Lord, we pray, God, that you would just be with all these names that are on the prayer request list, Lord. Touch them tonight, Lord, whether that need is healing, Lord, that need is understanding, Lord, or comfort, Lord. We pray, God, that you would just grant that tonight, Lord. God, just be with us as we go through this service, Lord, the song that's sung, Lord, the word that is brought, Lord. God, we just pray that you would place your holy anointing on it, Lord. Lord, just let it penetrate our hearts tonight, Lord. Just free our minds, Lord, of all distractions, Lord, and let us focus intently tonight on you, Lord. We love you and we thank you. All these things we pray and we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, Taylor is going to come and bring the special song, so be much in prayer for her.
Good evening. Hope everybody's having a fantastic night. If you'll notice, there's nothing on the screen behind me because it's not really anything to put up there. He asked me, he said, what are you preaching on tonight? You know? I said, no, I don't really know. And it wasn't a lie. I had a message prepared, and as we was pulling in, I got another message, and so now it's... We're going with the second version of what was for tonight, which is, full disclosure, it's a recycled message. It's a message I've already preached and preached several times before, but I feel like this is what God wants us to talk about tonight, so that's what we're going to do. And the title of this message, if it had one, would be a 1-2-3 relationship with God. I mean, it don't get any simpler than that, does it? 1-2-3 relationship with God. And that's essentially what we're all seeking, is a relationship with God. You know, salvation is the ultimate goal. But after salvation comes the relationship. And the relationship is one of the most important things that we will encounter in this life. It's one of the most important things after salvation that we can hope to achieve, is a healthy, lasting relationship with God. There's times where our relationship will stray far, and there's times where our relationship will be near. We're ebbs and flows. We drift in and we drift out of our relationship with God, and that's not a good thing. That's not a good thing. Our relationship with God should be consistent and stable. But we get caught up in the things of this world. We get caught up with what we're doing. We get caught up with life, as we like to call it. And we drift. So our first text tonight is coming out of Matthew chapter 6. We're going to look at verses 24 and 25. It's Matthew chapter 6, verses 24 and 25. If everyone would stand. In verse 24, he says, no man can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one and love the other, else he will hold to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and mammon. Therefore I say unto you, take no thought for your life, what you shall eat, what you shall drink, nor yet for your body, what you shall put on. Is not the life more than the meat, and the body more than the raiment? Let's pray. Father God, we thank you for the opportunity. We thank you for just being here with us and blessing us tonight as you've already done, God. We pray that you would just go with us through the next few minutes. I pray, God, that you would just allow me to be removed, Father God, and allow your spirit to be poured out, Father, over this congregation, and just allow the words to penetrate the soul, Father God, and not my words, but your words, God. I pray, Lord, that you would just remove me as far from this situation, this place, this pulpit as possibly can be, Father, and just allow it to be filled with you this evening. In Jesus' name, amen. So as we look at verses 24 and 25, we see that it's being told that you cannot serve God and man. So right there is our automatic conflict, because we are a self-serving bunch of people. We are a self-serving bunch of people. It's not so much about what God wants us to do as it is what we want to do. This is the mindset that we have to get away from. The first step in our relationship with God is to fully serve God. He tells us that you cannot serve two masters, for you'll either love the one and hate the other, you'll be loyal to one and you'll despise the other. You cannot serve God and mammon. You cannot serve God and money. You cannot serve God and man. You cannot serve God in any other ideology, whether it be monetary things of this world or physical things of this world, or other spiritual things. You cannot serve God and anything else. That's our first step in our relationship with God, is who are we serving? Are we serving God or are we serving self? So as we look through that, we see where he says, I say unto you, take no thought for your life, what you shall eat or what you shall drink, nor yet for your body, what you shall put on it. Is not the life more than meat, and the body more than raiment? Is not your life more than what you eat, and your body more than what you have on it? Now you may look up here and you say, oh, Chris is really snazzy tonight. Or you may look up here and you say, Chris is really dressed down tonight. It doesn't matter about what's on me. My wife is looking at me like, I didn't pick that out for you. It doesn't matter about what's on me. It matters about what's in me. It doesn't matter about what I put in my mouth to service my body. It matters what I put in my heart to service my spirit. We spend too much time caught up worrying about the things of this world that we drift away from God. And step one is our relationship with God. Step one in our relationship with God is establishing who we're serving and what we're doing for Him. In Romans chapter 8, we're going to look at what can separate us from the love of God. And I promise I have it marked. There it is. In Romans chapter 8, verses 35 through 39, it says, Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril of sword? As it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. So we look at our relationship and we've established who we're serving. So now we need to establish of what is capable of separating us from that service. Now we look here in Romans chapter 8, it clearly states a big long list of things that is incapable of separating us from the love of God, right? What's one thing it didn't put? You. It didn't put you in there. Because you have the ability to separate yourself from God. You have the ability to separate yourself from God in the sense that you walk away from Him. Now, God doesn't leave us. Once we accept Him as our Lord and Savior, He's there. He's not going anywhere. But we can step out of His will. And we have the ability to do that from time to time. At least I do. I know I'm not alone. We all have that ability. But he goes through and Paul writes this down of what can separate us from the love of God. And that's important. I want us to understand that word love being in there. Because we can separate ourselves from God. But God, we cannot separate ourselves from the love of God. Now he goes through this list and he lists off a massive list of things that, man, if we encountered half of them, we would fall. We would fall. But the second step of our relationship is understanding that we cannot be separated from the love of God. We've established who we're serving. Now we've established that there is no separation between us and Him when it comes to His love for us. The third thing that we're going to look at is how do we hold on? How do we keep from conforming to the things of this world? And that comes out of Romans chapter 12. Romans chapter 12 is one of my favorite books in the Bible, favorite chapters in the Bible. I mean, there's just so much to glean from Romans chapter 12. And I always look at these first three verses. And they just speak to me because it's so blunt and it's so to the point, matter of fact. How do we hold on to that relationship with God and not conform? He says in verse 1, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, wholly acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. For I say through the grace given unto me, to every man that is among you, not to think of himself more highly than he ought to think, but to think soberly according to God, according as God hath dealt to every man the measure of faith. Now I want us to go and look at verse 1, what he starts out with. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, I'm begging you, I implore you, I'm calling out to you by the mercies of God to present ourselves as a living sacrifice, to present ourselves in the image of Christ. Christ was that living sacrifice. So the way that we hold on to our relationship with God is not being conformed to this world, not partaking of the things of this world, not giving in to the things of this world as they pull and as they tug and as they drag you down. There's so many things in life that we're going to encounter that will hinder us and hamper us. But one of the main things that we have to hold on to is our relationship with God. He says to not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. That speaks for itself. For I say through the grace given unto me to every man that is among you, not to think of himself more highly than he ought to think, but to think soberly according as God has dealt to every man that measure of faith. So the way that we are able to have and hold on to our relationship with God is we establish who we're serving, we establish what can and cannot separate us, and we establish how we hold on to that. Now, Brother Michael told me to bring a short message tonight. So this is the message, okay? It's short, it's sweet, there's no frills to it. I can go on for another 45 minutes about things, but that's the meat. And I feel like that's where we're supposed to go with it tonight, is straight to the point of what our relationship with Christ should be. Now, everybody's relationship's going to look different. Not everybody's going to serve in the same capacity or the same way. And that's okay, because it takes many members to make up the body. I think maybe I'm the pinky toenail or the fungus underneath the pinky toenail. That's okay, because I'm part of the body. And I know that my relationship with Christ lacks at times. And I know that there's times when it flourishes. So we're going to dismiss in a word of prayer tonight. I'm going to ask Brother Chris if he would to dismiss us.